Hello and welcome back to the channel. Today's video is all about how I approach practice in my art journey, and I'll let you in on a secret of mine, so keep watching. First up, let's talk about practice. There are two approaches to practice, the daily grind and steady flow. We all dream of becoming the next artistic legend, right? But between work, family, and other commitments, carving time out for art can feel like a daily battle. The daily grind approach asks for showing up every single day, come hell or high water. While this may work for full-time artists, but for many of us, especially part-time artists or hobbyists, forcing daily practice can lead to burnt outs, artistic blocks, feeling like art is a chore. That's where the power of steady flow or regular practice comes in. It's about consistency, not flexibility. I picked up art seriously about 5 years ago and started practicing regularly along with my school, coaching classes, and even university. I used to put a break on it during exams, but kept on it otherwise. And I could not have been where I am today if I didn't practice enough. If anything, I used to feel bad for not practicing enough, but I've started to understand and embrace all the times I kept practicing. So it's always better to schedule dedicated art time into your week, even if it's just a few hours. But listen to your body and your mind. You can start with 10 minutes quick sketches and increase the time at your own comfort and pace. If you're exhausted, forcing yourself to paint might lead to sloppy work, sense of failure. So step away, recharge, and come back later when your creative well is overflowing. Remember, regular, focused session can lead to amazing results. You might be surprised how more you can accomplish when you are feeling inspired and energized. Because after all, art should be a source of joy and not a chore. I ordered some new art supplies and I can't wait to show you guys what I got. First up, I got these adorable mini sketchbooks, and these are going to be part of my regular practice since these are small enough for quick sketches. Next up, I got these big canvases. When I say big, I mean bigger than my face. And I've never painted on something of this size. These stretch canvases are really special for me because I'm going to turn these into my first ever collection. Yes, I can't believe that I'm saying this because I had never imagined I'll reach this stage in my art journey. This series is extremely special to me because it's going to be a reflection of my own emotions. Lastly, I have some wooden blocks which are going to be mini version of this upcoming collection. I already have some experience of painting on wooden blocks and they look very unique, so these are going to be perfect. Overall, I'm so excited about these new goodies. Thanks for joining me on this art adventure. If you are new here and would like to see more of the art tutorials, creative inspiration, and of course, more fun hauls, make sure to subscribe and don't forget to like this video.